Good morning, class 11. Well, in continuation with the chapter correlation, where already in my previous video I've explained to you the degree of correlation. So today in this video you will be doing the different methods of estimating correlation. Well, children, though there are number of methods available for estimating correlation between different set of statistical series, but some of the important methods are classified as graphic correlation and algebraic correlation. So when we talk about graphic, it is further classified as into a scatter diagram method, and algebraic into a Karl-Pearson coefficient of correlation and Spearman's rank correlation of coefficient. So we are going to study about these methods only. So let's start with the first one, that is the scatter diagram. Now children, when we talk about the scatter diagram, then these diagrams actually offers a graphic expression of the direction and degree of correlation. And to make a scatter diagram, what you need to do is that on a graph paper, a data plotted. Then a dot is marked for each value. And then these dots, they have been joined together, which indicate the direction and closeness of the variables. Now if you see the given pictures of the scatter diagram, which shows some of the possible directions and the degrees of closeness of the variables. As from the given diagrams, it is very much clear that closeness of the dots towards each other in a particular direction actually indicates a higher degree of correlation. And if the dots are scattered, showing neither the closeness nor any direction, it is an indication of low degree of correlation. So if you see the first diagram, that is the first one, A, where it is showing the perfect positive relation, where R equals to plus 1. When we say perfect positive relation, though already I have explained to you before also, which means that here the relationship between the two variable is perfectly positive, means that the proportional change in two variable is in the same direction. So coefficient of correlation is positive, that is plus 1. If you see the second diagram, B1, where R equals to minus 1, means it's a perfect negative. That means that over here the correlation is perfectly negative, where the proportionate change in two variable is in opposite direction. So here the coefficient of correlation is negative. If you can see, it is coming down from left to right, whereas in the first diagram it is going up from left to right. Now if you see the C1, which is again moving up one, that is showing the positive relationship. So when we talk about a positive correlation, means where the two variables, they are moving in the same direction. This means that if one increases, other also increases. If one decreases, other also decreases. So children, such relationship is called a positive relationship. If we see the D diagram, which is showing a negative relationship, means a negative correlation. That means when two variables, they change in different opposite direction. Rather, they are not moving in the same direction, but they are in the opposite direction. So here we say that the relationship between the two variables is negative, right? Then if you see the last one, E diagram, where the dots are totally scattered. They are scattered means they are not showing any closeness nor any direction. So if they are not showing any closeness nor any direction, that is an indication of low degree of correlation or no relation. In fact, you need to say there is no correlation. So children, these different five scattered diagrams show the different relationship between the two variables. Here you need to remember that these scattered diagrams is a very simple way of studying the correlation between the two variables, which shows either there is a relationship between two values or there is no relationship between the two variables. And at the same time, they also indicate whether the relation between the two variables is positive or negative. Right? Now, let's see how we can plot a scatter diagram. Now, if you all can see, there are two variables, x and y. And the values of x variable is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And if we see, the values of y is 2, 3, 2, 5, 10 and 15. Where we have taken x, y to be as 1 and 2, then 2 and 3, 3 and 2, 4 and 5, 5 and 10 and 6 and 15. So children, we have plotted this into a diagram, where on the x-axis we have taken the x values, on the y-axis we have taken the values of y. And accordingly, if you see that on the x-axis you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 values, on the y-axis you have a values of 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 and 16. And now, keeping the values in mind, we have put the dot. Right? Now, if you see these dots, okay, this diagram, it shows that there is a positive relationship somewhere because the dots are moving upward from left to right. As they are moving upward from left to right, so children, it shows that with the increase in one variable, the other variable also increases. However, this is a case of limited positive correlation because the dots, they are not making any of the straight line. So children, this is how you all can plot a scatter diagram and can show a relationship between the two different variables, whether the variables, they show a positive relationship or whether they show a negative.